Welcome, woman. Welcome to Sweeter Than Honey. Will you pray with me? Dear Father in heaven, we thank you that the Savior has been with us on the earth, and that in our day, we can still follow him and wait for your will and your rulership. For you are Almighty God, and your kingdom must come, your will must be done, and all promises must be fulfilled. Carry out your will, we ask and beseech you. Establish your kingdom among all nations, even if today this is possible with only a few. For through your working, hearts can change so that your name may be praised and all promises may be fulfilled. Thanks be to you for allowing us to live in such great hope. Stay by us in our work on earth so that it may be done in your service. In every situation, deepen our longing for the Savior to come and establish your kingdom. Be with us during the night and bless us in your greatness and faithfulness. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God's words for today comes from Numbers chapter 22, verse 21 through 35. Numbers chapter 22, verse 21 through 35. We will be reading from the NRSV, so please carefully follow along and hear the word of the Lord. So Balaam got up in the morning, saddled his donkey, and went with the officials of Moab. God's anger was kindled because he was going, and the angel of the Lord took his stand in the road as his adversary. Now he was riding on the donkey, and his two servants were with him. The donkey saw the angel of the Lord standing in the road with a drawn sword in his hand. So the donkey turned off the road and went into the field. And Balaam struck the donkey to turn it back on the road. Then the angel of the Lord stood in a narrow path between the vineyards with the wall on either side. When the donkey saw the angel of the Lord, it scraped against the walls and scraped Balaam's foot against the wall. So he struck it again. The angel of the Lord went ahead and stood in a narrow place, where there was no way to turn either to the right or to the left. When the donkey saw the angel of the Lord, it lay under Balaam, and Balaam's anger was kindled, and he struck the donkey with his staff. Then the Lord opened the mouth of the donkey and said to Balaam, "What have I done to you that you have struck me these three times?" Balaam said to the donkey, "Because you have made a fool of me. I wish I had a sword in my hand. I would kill you right now." But the donkey said to Balaam, "Am I not your donkey, which you have ridden all your life to this day? Have I been in the habit of treating you this way?" And he said, "No." Then the Lord opened the eyes of Balaam, and he saw the angel of the Lord standing in the road, with his drawn sword in his hand, and then he bowed down, falling on his face. The angel of the Lord said to him, "Why have you struck down your donkey these three times? I have come out as an adversary because your way is perverse before me. The donkey saw me and turned away from me these three times. If it had not turned away from me, surely just now I would have killed you and let it live." Then Balaam said to the angel of the Lord, "I have sinned, for I did not know that you were standing in the road to oppose me. Now therefore, if it is displeasing to you, I will return home." The angel of the Lord said to Balaam, "Go with the men, but speak only what I tell you to speak." So Balaam went on with the officials of Balak. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. So what we have here is, so far we've been reading the story of Balak and Balaam. Balak is the king of the Moabites, and he wants Balaam to come and curse the Israelites. Balaam has the power to bless or curse, and so Balak thinks that if he curses the Israelites, then surely the people of God would be cursed and would turn away from his borders of his kingdom, because he was afraid of what the Israelites could do. Now Balaam, in his dreams and his visions, God comes and says, you know, don't go with him. But Balak urges Balaam to come, and God says, go ahead and go. And what we have here is Balaam is riding his donkey, and as he's going, the Balaam sees that the angel of the Lord is in his way. And you might think, well, God said to go, so why is he all of a sudden sending an angel to kind of block his way? Well, I think the message here is this, that although he is going, the command stands that God does not plan on cursing his people, right? And so the donkey, the angel of the Lord kind of stands for God's displeasure and displease with what Balak still wants. And the wishes of God and Balak are different. And so what we have here is Balaam doesn't know that God, the angel, is there. So he kind of tells the donkey to go on. Reprimands him with a staff, right? And kind of tells the donkey that I would kill you if I had a sword. And this happens three times. And what this represents is this. Balaam and his donkey represent him and Balak. Basically, Balaam is the donkey. So donkey should not go where Balaam, who represents Balak, should go. Meaning, God is asking Balaam at this moment, do you know what I want from you? Do you know what I am asking of you? And so basically, at the end of the day, Balaam is to listen to God and do what God wants him to do. And God is saying listening to his commands is more important than the whips or the threats or even the fear of what Balak might do to him. And so the donkey, even though Balaam is his owner, right? Even though Balaam has the power to kill him, he would not dare cross before the angel of the Lord. And so we ask ourselves today, and the things that we do, and the things that we do in our lives, the things that we think that God is telling us to do in our lives, and we ask, is this truly the command of God? Is this what God desires? And sometimes it's not just easy as, is this what God wants or not? You have to know what God wants you to do. And that requires you to know the Word of God. So my question to you today is, do you know what God wants? And do you know what God desires from you? And are you doing what God desires you to do? Because as our scripture says today, it's critical. It's even life-worthy to follow what God says more than what the world or what we desire to do in our hearts. So I pray that may we have the wisdom today, the discernment and the connection and the listens to hear, ears to listen, to hear what God wants us to do. Let's pray. God, we thank you so much for this time. We thank you for loving us. Help us to do what you desire. In our passage today, we see that following you is very important. Help us to do it faithfully. Help us to be wise and help us to have ears to listen to what you desire from us. Therefore, may we do what you want us to do, and may we follow your commands every day. In Jesus Christ, whom we pray. Amen.